Was it, you said something about absent, what, huh?
It was number five.
Number five? Did I don't, didn't even write this down here.
Page two.
Page two. Well, do you want me to explain it again, or do you got it?
We got it.
You got it. Okay. Okay. Oh, that's right. I remember now. Okay. So, today we're forced to leave here with 35. Okay. So we got some time to kind of. So here's what I'm gonna do. Let's everybody grab a piece of graph paper, and we're going to have a little discovery lesson on what the graph of an inverse looks like. Okay? And then,
that's so long ago.
Geometry, I don't need, yeah. There's geometry. Won't take long. All right, won't take long. Okay, you can go ahead and take this board. Thank you, sir. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at and investigate.
I should have a box of pens down there by your right knee.
Yep, you did.
Some of this we're going to do in pencil, some we're going to do it in pen just so you can see the difference between the two. Okay. Tom, do you have that written down? Project tomorrow and hopefully get I'm working on putting a screened in porch on the back of somebody's little building for them. We ran out of shingles before, so they bought some shingles, and last weekend, since I didn't have any shingles, I built two sets of steps and started putting up some railing. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. We're just gonna go ahead and draw a, and I'm gonna do this in pen. Did I not give you pens? I have not given you pens. I wanna throw stuff at you, I forgot. Okay. So, I'm going to go ahead and do this in pen, okay, so I'm just giving myself a little axis. You can see that I'm using up probably about a fourth of the paper. So now what I'm going to do is we're just going to go ahead and put a line on here, and let's all use the same line, please. Let's go up, let's go up 8. These grids are actually 1/8-inch grids, and there's a darker line every inch, which is 8 grids. So, and then I'm just going to go like 2 grids to the left. So it's got an x-intercept of -2 and a y-intercept of 8. Now what I want you to do is I want you to very carefully make sure you draw a line with your pen going through those two points. Okay?
Mr. Richard, are you a dart player?
A dart player? I have played some darts in the past.
but not a big dark one.
What?
I once threw three bullseyes. That was a long time ago. Okay, so now let's go ahead and say that this was my f of x. So now what do we know about the inverse? What would the inverse look like? Well, let's do this from a point-by-point standpoint instead of an equation standpoint. This point right here is negative 2, 0. I'm going to go to a different color. You can go to your pencil or whatever. I do think it's going to be nice to have them a little bit different. Okay. So if negative 2, 0 is on my function, what's going to be on my inverse?
0, positive 8.
0, negative 2. Okay. And this point up here is 0, 8. So what point's going to be on my inverse? 8, 0. Okay. So now I'm just going to go ahead and graph that line. And I wonder how those two things relate to each other. How does the one line relate to the other? Well, we probably don't have enough information yet to really get a picture, so we're going to have to do another one. What our goal is to figure out how the blue graph relates to the red graph. Okay. So let's go ahead and do one more, and we'll see if we can get you a little bit clearer picture of what's going on. Let's go ahead and we can just do this underneath. Going back to my pen, it doesn't really matter necessarily, but it's just nice to have some different color stuff here. And okay, what am I gonna do? Okay. I'm just gonna put some points on here. 0, 5. Three, eight, negative 3, 0. Thank you, sir. Negative 4, negative 8. And what the heck? Let's go 4, 12. Now granted, we don't look at functions like this really, but good luck tonight. Go get them. Don't take off your helmet and beat other people with it. Yeah. So I'm going to go ahead and have you graph that one. And then you can start graphing the inverse. So, if we go, let's see. Have you figured out how they're related to each other yet? How are they related to each other? Opposite, but what mechanical thing? A reflection? Okay. So what we've got is it's the same shape, but I agree it's been flipped. But what's it been flipped over? What line? What line is it being flipped over? Because if we think about it, this point goes to that point, this point is going to that point, but on the other hand, that point comes up here.
It's being flipped over the origin.
Flipped over the origin? There's a line. There's a line that it's getting flipped over. What is that line? What would be the equation of the line that's getting flipped over? X equals y. X equals y. Because if I would draw this line, y equals x, which goes through 0, 0, 2, 2, you see that the points that are on the top side of this line, y equals x, those are being flipped down to the bottom. And the points that are on the bottom of this line, y equals x, are being flipped over to the top. And this one, it's going away from the line y equals x, and now that's how we're going to finish. It's going away from the line y equals x. Okay? So what it is it's a reflection over the line y equals x. Any inverse, you can just take the original points, or the original graph, and we can fold it over that line. That part's been folded this way, that part's been folded up. Okay? So, here's what we're going to do. I probably should have told you to grab two pieces of graph paper. Let's go grab another piece of graph paper, and I'm going to show you something that's kind of neat. Can you grab one for me too, Shane? Okay, so now what we're going to do is let's just do a big one. Let's do a big old axis here. I suppose you could, but it's not going to be pretty. It's not going to be pretty, and you might see what I'm talking about as far as it causing problems. I'm going to do the whole stinking page, man. I'm going to just do the whole page. Okay, and now we're just going to do a function. You can basically do whatever you want. Remember the vertical line test? Just, I would make sure it passes the vertical line test. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do something like this. And yours can look like whatever it wants to. Okay, So just go ahead and draw a graph. It's all connected and just kind of sweeps and goes up and down. You can do it. Yours can look different. Yours can have more humps than mine. Yours can have fewer humps than mine. And then we're going to show you kind of how this all works. You can do whatever you want. I'd rather not, but in this case, it's not really critical if it does or doesn't. Okay. So now, this is where people have a tendency to get confused. I'm going to ask you to fold a piece of paper. Dun, dun, dun. And I'm going to ask you to fold it in a very specific way. I am going to ask you, so like say, here's my graph. I am going to ask you to fold it so this x-axis gets folded onto the y-axis. And what I would recommend is keep your drawing on the outside. Okay? So what you can do is I want you to fold it. You might need to look up at the lights or whatever, but I want you to fold it so your positive x-axis ends up exactly on top of your positive y-axis. And you should, if you do that right, you should end up with a line y equals x. And again, I would keep your writing on the outside. That's going to serve a good purpose later on. Okay. Okay, I think that looks good. Did you keep your writing on the outside?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay. And for reasons you might not understand right now, I want this column right here, I want you guys to move over. I want this column right here, I want you to move over so there's about a foot and a half, 2 feet in between you guys and those windows. Come over to the window and you can go ahead and, because what I need is like say this hump, I need on the other side. So I can go ahead and take look here and I can just trace that hump on the opposite side. So what our goal is to get the entire thing traced to the other side. Does that make sense?
Yep.
So you can come on up. I'll get out of the area here. And we are going to...
You're going to overlap with it?
Yeah. Yep. Take everything and flip it over to the other side. Go ahead. We have three windows to work with. You can even go above the air conditioner if you need to.
Okay.
I would like a nice, smooth, continuous graph in the other color or whatever, however you want to do it. Okay?
What if we forgot to do the...
I don't care. It's not critical. What's scary? So it's really kind of neat though, what's happening though, is because you got some points that are being flipped to one side, points that are being flipped to the other side, and it kind of gets all lost in one big lumpy mess, but you can pick any point and it got folded to the opposite side. You can pick this point and it got folded to the opposite side. You can take this point and it got that point and it got folded to the opposite side. So the reason why that is because you guys already know that my point xy on my inverse turns into the point yx. Because your x and y flip, right? Okay. So instead of going over and up, now I'm going up and over. So it's just doing it reversed, okay? But that's one of the main things about an inverse is, two main things, is that, you know, it does undo another function, and the graph is very much related to its original graph. But it's just been reflected over that line y equals x. So that's kind of cool. Okay, I forget. What did we... Yes, I did. I just didn't write it down. I don't have it here. 1 through 6?
Yeah,
3. Okay. Well, let's do this. Today, very short. Page 276. Fifty-seven, and I want to see your work with this. You're not just getting the answers from the back, please. And we'll do 58. Just three problems. You can do them wherever you want.
Would you like
to
have to keep
these? No. I just wanted you guys to see an example of, you know, and you guys figured it out after a couple graphs. You figured it out kind of on your own. Well, that's good. So three problems on finding inverses, and then we'll probably move on here next week. Yeah, just on your way out, you guys can just go ahead and put them in the box. All right.
I would appreciate it. Mm-hmm. See you later, folks. Have a great weekend. If you're playing, good luck. If you're not, cheer your lungs out, because great for OC schools.
What do you want to do with the pens?
The pens?
We'll walk out.
Yeah, put them in the box and you can walk out. NFL hits Browns Garrett with an indefinite ban. No, it's not necessarily. He ripped the guy's helmet off and then hit him with the helmet.
That is kind of funny, though.
I don't think so.
There's a little bit of dark in there. I have a question. Isn't it just a little bit cold out for the shoe milk? You get like the cotton with the shoe milk a little bit?
It's in a situation where there's no wind at all. So when
it's one of those types I see. And it'll stay like that in like summer and then it'll sleep there.
Exactly. Yep. Hello?
It was a burglar, or was it? It was, he was trying to steal things.
But you didn't listen to him, did you?
I know it wasn't easy to see.
That's exactly what you did,
you
right?
You shot him in the leg, and you put one right through the kneecap, right?
Yeah. I sang you around.
You really are, isn't it?
Yeah, you must
be so proud of your son, Jack. Special award for courage, right? We have a photograph of that award ceremony. Let's take a look.
Oh, look, it's not even the same
Thank you.
Thank you.
As long as I don't find wrappers on the floor. Oh, bad toss on my part. That was...
Thank you.
You bet.
Thank you.
They're half price at DG.
Thank you.
What are you? Bargains. Yeah? No, I didn't. No, I didn't forget you. I went Trevor, Carter, and then reloaded and went... Said I was just too smart. What, huh? Because honestly, your brain starts trying to move on to the next words, and You know, it's just.
Wait, so people with Tourette's are like really, really funny.
I didn't say that.
Apple that can't talk.
He
couldn't even walk. He was so smart, he couldn't even walk.
I really wish it. What?
You're still recording on there.
Hey, I'm still recording. Hey.
Oh my God.
How long have I been recording for?
62
minutes. Okay.